Hello, welcome back. How are you?
Here, let's shake our elbows. Yes.
How are you? Do you hate me a lot or just a little bit?
She never really talked about it around me until I was a little older and we could start seeing the symptoms of it. And then she just started explaining like kind of what she had and what I could possibly go through in the future.
The condition we're talking about today is called facioscapulohumeral dystrophy. In essence, what happens is that the muscles that control the position of the shoulder blade in space start to get weaker and weaker and weaker over time. Then the shoulder blades start to migrate off the chest wall, and it really affects the function of the upper extremity of the patient.
I've had to rely on my mom a lot. She went through this with me, and going through it on the parenting side of it has been very, very different than being the one that's personally having the procedure. In a lot of ways, I think, even though this surgery is really hard and painful and difficult, that was easier than watching him go through it.
I wasn't blind going into this surgery or having this condition, and I had somebody that I could talk to if I had any questions about it.
It was very difficult, very, very difficult to watch him go through it. And in some ways, it was easier because I knew the benefits coming out of it.
This procedure is somewhat uncommon, which basically involves physically connect the shoulder blade to the ribs. And typically, that bone graft comes from the patient's own pelvic waistline. Those are moved to the space between the ribs and the shoulder blade and compressed with the cables on the plate.
Whatever I was going through, I knew she'd already been through it. So I could always ask her how she got through this or what she did when she was in this situation. So it was just nice to have somebody that's done it, that knows what they're talking about, that can relate to it, and that can feel the type of sympathy for me that nobody else can.
So once the shoulder blade, the scapula, heals to the ribs, it's a major improvement in their quality of life.
The ability that I had for the last 24 years, I have been able to hold and lift and carry my babies. And I wouldn't have necessarily had that ability before.
If I didn't get this procedure, like playing sports with my friends, it's just kind of nice to know that I'm not going to lose out on all that now because of this surgery and because of the work that I've been able to have done here. It just makes my future brighter.
The fact that he's going to have the ability to go live a pretty normal life, he has a very bright future. And that to me is a gift.